Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Gamer Donnie channel here on YouTube. I'm Gamer Donnie, and we're going to play some American Truck Simulator. Now, you know me, I'm always looking for a good challenge, and I think I might have bit off more than I could chew with this one. But I'm going to give it a good old college try anyway, you know. We're up here in Alaska, Prudhoe Bay, right? This is furthest north that we can get. We'll go all the way down to Fairbanks, which is here. That's 608 miles, says 13.5 hours to get there. Which the road's not that big of a deal really. There is some spots that are pretty hairy. The real problem is, there, let me show you. There's a damn blizzard going on. I can't see shit. We've got these two, well, got a B train. It's just easier to use a B train than to deal with the little dollies for the second trailer. Anyways, we got a B train here, loaded down with 46,846 pounds of empty pallets. We're gonna take up to the Carlisle in Fairbanks if we can get out of here. So that's gonna be the big challenge. So you got the DDC Peterbilt 379s. It got 3408 Caterpillar in it with an 18 speed with a 411 gear differential on it. Yeah, let's see if we can do this. I don't know how long it's going to take, but I've only been through here once before. But if we can get out of this place, it'll be a good place to start. Fortunately, I don't have no mod in to make it snow. I wish I did. I tried to find just the snow mod itself. I have to do the whole frosty winter because I got PNG installed Project Next Gen, and I'd have to remove that and then put his in, and then I'd have to remove it and put PNG back in after I got done. And then risk breaking the game, and I don't want to do that. So, plus I couldn't really find a good Frosty's mod for 1.47 anyway. So that's the deal for today. We're gonna have to get some fuel. Yeah. Even foggy inside the damn truck. I gotta figure out how to get out of here. I got a GPS and it just, I don't know, it doesn't show no road or anything. Let's see what we can do here. That's enough talking. Get some action going. Got our lights on, yep. Okay. We're doing all we can do then. Is slick too. You seen there it is, just started spinning on me. There it goes again. Gotta ease on that throttle. Say the road's like right through here somewhere, maybe. Nope, over here. I see it now. Yeah, I don't even know if this is gonna be possible, man. I can't see nothing. Was nighttime. I've changed the time to daytime, thinking hell I'd be able to see a little bit better, but I think it actually made it worse. Brights don't help any. I don't have no chains on this thing either, so it'll make it a little bit more challenging. Hoping as we get going further south, the weather will clear up. But I'm not holding my breath on it. And they're just flying through here too. Everything's coming or not, it doesn't look like it. Fuck, where's the road? I can't see the road. put those little markers on the side of the road, or little reflectors, but don't need that engine brake on. First time we got on this load, 26 hours. Almost saying we just advance the time and see what happens. It's 5 a.m., 5:30. We gotta get fuel too. We better mark that on the map or I'll forget it. We gotta get all the way. I passed the fuel spot, didn't I? Yeah. Down here. We might be able to refuel at the terminal there. I don't know if I can get this thing in there to get fuel at the terminal. Yeah, some snow would definitely make it a lot better, but I can make it rain. What the hell's going on? We'll say we're still on the road. I haven't filled the bump or anything yet, so. Oh, shit. Driving back into the sun. Oh, mother trucker. Just kind of following the dark lines there on the road. Ooh, don't want to hit that snowbank. Yeah. About this one, like I said, I'm gonna give it a try. Black is all the way. It'll be a long ass trip. Shit, where'd the road go? Glad somebody's paying attention. It's alright if you're not driving into the sun. You can actually kind of see the road a little bit. Once you get facing towards that sun, though, it's a whole nother ball game. Advance the time an hour or two and see what happens. Maybe this is just the way it's supposed to be. I don't know. What is that? Off in the ditch. They got the crane out. is just stupid right here. Why the hell would you even drive this stuff? Another vehicle coming, I think. Well, if you turn the brights on, you'd be able to see those reflectors better, but doesn't work like that, I don't guess. Can you see that last trailer back there? This is that Alaska North to the Future map. Oof. That's a snowbank. Snowbank will break the bank. Weather wasn't like this when I came up here to pick this load up, which is dark too, so I can still see pretty good, but it changes once we get up here. I don't think I'm gonna be holding my breath on it though. Kind of leaning, lining the left side of this truck up the left tire with that dark spot in the middle of the road there. Alright, well, we gotta turn somewhere. Stop signs. Ooh, we can't see shit. I think there's a road. I need the road. There's the road. Know if we're gonna be able to find the gas pumps. Is it the road or is this the road? I guess it's the road. Two. Could be. Damn, broke each other in half. Yeah, I see something there. Take on some fuel, because we're not going to be going anywhere without fuel. $3.12 damage, sheep up here. I'll load the trailer up with fuel and take it down here and sell it for $6 a gallon. I think it'd cost more up here, but apparently not. Okay, I'm gonna take a nap and we'll give it an hour or two. It's 6 o'clock now, 6, 7, 8. We'll go until about 9 o'clock. Should be good. 9 there. Let's try 8 first. Yeah, let's do 8. There we go. Now we can see. Trust me, it's probably going to be whiteout conditions again, so. Almost feels like cheating using a time advance like that. What the hell? I'm taking a nap. I mean, that's what I'd do in real life. If the weather's like that, I'd pull over, take me a nap or something. Nap and a crap. I like his truck. What's in that? So we gotta make a right turn up here somewhere. I'd say the road and stuff looks pretty damn good. Greyhound bus doing up here? One hell of a ticket. I don't think I could sit on a bus that long. How much weight we at? 46,000? That ain't too bad. Hardest part's gonna be climbing the hills. We just gotta make sure we get enough speed picked up. Not miss a gear. We should have been on this side of the fucking road. I was off in the ditch. Give a little, take a little. Didn't damage my treasure or anything, did it? No, I think the truck already had a little damage on it. Kind of ran a sign over earlier. It is in the way. What can I say? Got snow blowing across the road. Pretty good. Fuel and everything, we should be good to go for a while. We should be able to get there actually. Like there's one more fuel stop between here and there. We'll probably stop and fill up just to be on the safe side. It really depends on how much fuel we got when we get there, I guess. Thing that wind doesn't have an effect on the truck. It'd be rocking back and forth like crazy. How's everybody been doing? You guys been doing pretty good? I'm doing alright considering the situation that I'm in. Yeah, we're not gonna be able to do above 40. And I got it to the floor. Anybody heard any news about that Alaska truck driving game that's supposed to come out? Like a truck driving slash survival? I'll give it a try. It looks interesting. A change, that's for sure. Stop and put oil in the truck and everything every so many miles. Back her down. Got a brake check. Let's go. Not eighth. I'm looking for four. The engine that comes with this truck, you get like, I don't know, a whole bunch of different engines with the paid version anyway. A lot more than what you'd get with the free. Then I had to add my transmissions in and my differential ratios. We're supposed to be on the ice. This shit's flooded. He's off in the ditch, off in the bush. It's spinning a little bit there. Breaker 1-9, how about you, flatbed? How about you get the fuck out of the way, buddy? Ooh, there's a line of them. I was gonna pass them, but if there's one or two, I would, but I don't know about three. Seven flows too low and six highs too high. This will just stay in six high. I believe the torque range on this engine is between 12 and 1500 RPM. Oh, it's like another torque range. Gives you a good idea when you should shift. Torque range is 12 through 15. Oh, and downshift until you hit 12 or under. Little turbos are whistling. Load the phone. We ain't got no air pressure. Oh, well, yeah, we do. Okay, that gauge must not work then. I should have done this at night time. It would have looked better. Oh well, whatever. It is what it is. -2 degrees Fahrenheit outside. actually what it says is going to take us 10 hours, 11 hours to go 500 miles. I think it's all snow covered road from here to Cobut, Fairbanks. Isn't that where we're going? Yeah. Downhill and gets the speed picked up. I'm having fun back underneath that tanker trailer, ain't he? The big no-no. Everyone hook it in the snow like that. Truck will just back up to the trailer and it'll just sit there and spin. Then you gotta raise the trailer up, back the truck up just a little bit so where it's sitting on the fifth wheel. Lower it back down, then back up, and hopefully you're still back underneath it. There's a big pipeline. Grandma's laid a lot of pipe in her day. Miles and miles of pickers come her way. Greyhound bus. Where the hell's all these people going on those buses? Lights on for safety. It'll be there by 9 p.m. Maybe. We'll get stuck on a hill. I think that this load isn't that heavy, so we should do alright as long as we don't miss a gear. We do that, then we're gonna be screwed. Cause you can back this thing up, but it's a pain in the ass. Comes those whiteout conditions again. Truck up here in Alaska. Better than a damn Swift, I guess. Engine's kind of got a weird sound to it. Who the fuck would live up here? Truck world either. Of course, it's been a day or two since I checked it. So. Change if available. Oh shit. Well, we ain't got no change. We can let this traffic go by though. That's like a repair shop, isn't it? Yeah, I ain't got no change. Could have put the snowy tire mod and chain mod in, but. Look at all that traffic. All right. Come on, get in the gear. That's already spinning. Speed picked up. Missed that gear and it screwed it up. Gauntlet right here. How, just how good of a driver are you, driver? It it'd be cool if you get a convoy going out through here. So that'd be pretty neat. Here we go up the hill. Screw up, it's gonna be from 5th low to 4th high. That can be kind of tricky to nail sometimes, especially going through the hills. Back on a little bit, but these things would really start going wrong, so I'm just gonna keep my mouth shut. We're gonna drift around a curve. Oh, there's Swift. We're all fucked now. It wasn't just anyone, it's the doubles too. Good of a driver or are you, driver? Well, at least it ain't too bad of a whiteout condition. I don't know if you'd even call this a whiteout. Yeah, I think you would. Definitely like when we first started. I got 350 miles to go. Holy shit. Downshift. Wait for it. And I'll be alright, yeah. Hit that torque range. Gonna take the big 30 axle boiler one down through here, but I can't get it to spawn in Prudhoe Bay or Fairbanks or anywhere in Alaska. Actually, like I gotta go in there and edit the file and add it in, I think, which I don't know how to do. Always figure it out though. Just now figured out how to add transmissions and engines to the truck. Don't do too good with tutorials. Can't ever remember them. I gotta be able to get my hands on it and feel it and do it myself. I have somebody telling me how to do it while I'm doing it. Getting thicker. Almost a cold foot. And we're going to have fuel. Turning right up here somewhere. Here it is. What the fuck that is, but it's one of those tractors. Got our lights on, so we're good there. I was going to use that Kenworth C500, the twin stair axle truck, the whole one of the big boilers, but when I figure out how to do it, then I'll just have to hold off on it. Ain't no fucking road. Not what we need. That's a good thing about having a B double. You can actually back it up if you have to. I mean, it's a little tricky, but it can be done. That's just great. Can't see shit. Excuse me, got the hiccups. Smoking the bandit there for a minute. Sound like the old Kenworth firing up. This is bullshit. I'll stop and take a nap for an hour. Negative 33. Damn. Thank you, little bus. Push on, I guess. End up in the ditch, aren't we? Ain't too bad. At least you could actually see the road. Can't see much of it, but you can see it. They would throw road correction. Need to break off. Oh, he's shoveling a pile of gravel this time. He's not pickaxing it. Figure out what the hell you're gonna pickaxe a pile of gravel for, but okay. In the middle of the fucking road. Go figure. Slow down, driver. Brake check. that time. I did turn the bitrate up on the video on their encoder, so be a little bit better. I haven't seen the very many cops, but it's not like we go over the speed limit even if we wanted to. The way the trees look at nighttime, that's pretty cool. After midnight, we're gonna let it all hang out. Miles. How much money I'm gonna get out of this? 34,000, that's it? Fuck. Screwed in the ass, didn't get a kiss on the neck. Slide that fifth wheel forward a little bit, running and sliding around, a little bit more weight on it. Ooh, there it goes. It's sliding, it catched. I just went around them like I was going to do. Starting to rain. Getting a little bit of everything. Daytime, nighttime, rain, whiteout conditions. They plan on making Alaska, or just going to do the lower states. And Alaska is part of America. America. Ooh, come on, turn. It's only 40. Take a fuel lift. Thing doesn't have no onboard computer. Tells you what your fuel mileage and everything is. I can imagine it's probably pretty shitty. ETOA was Friday at 9 o'clock, 9:30. That's Saturday at midnight, a little after midnight. Range is when I should have been splitting. See that? I just seen Bigfoot. I would be the Sasquatch here, wouldn't I? Or the other. This hasn't been that bad, really. I thought it was going to be a lot worse, to tell you the truth. I'm just that good of a driver. And I did miss a gear or two there. Ran off in a ditch, yeah, so that's a plus. Close to Fairbanks, and she's some paved road. There we go. I'm kind of disappointed, actually. I thought it was going to be worse now. Maybe we need to try it with triples. We can do quads. We do quad, I don't know if they have quad 53 foot. I know they got a double. Or a triple, I mean. They do have a triple 53 foot trailers. A quad, little bitty gas trailers, like what are they, 20 something feet, 28 feet, something like that. Pups. That would be the name of them. Making that money. Money. It's a gas. Don't fall and bust your ass. I want to see if I get that big one, 32-axled boiler trailer going. Add it in. That would be a good challenge. Do some fishing. Catch you some tuna. Swordfish, something like that. Turn the jig break back up, stage 3. Not in the snow anymore. Welcome to Fairbanks, everybody. Fairbanks, Alaska. Been a hell of a trip. That's pretty enjoyable. I enjoyed that. Wasn't quite as challenging as I thought it was going to be, but still nice to do every once in a while. I still don't have my GPS voice on. Alright, you know what? Hold on a sec. What is the point of stopping? I don't get it. Okay, whatever. Make no sense to have a stop sign there, but sure. Yeah, what do you got going on here, party? American circle. Okay. Bam! 605 miles, 20 hours, 37 minutes, 309.7 gallons of fuel burn, 34,554. And 1,510 XP. Level 36. We're almost 37. We got like, what, 37? There, yeah, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, looks about right. I hope you guys enjoyed. It wasn't quite as challenging as I thought it was going to be, but I still enjoyed it nonetheless. So, hope you guys have a wonderful day. Thank you for stopping by and watching. We'll see you in the next one.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and leave a comment down below. We'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.